So good morning everyone. In the last session we have learnt about the solid liquid separation process by use of a continuous centrifuge, that is vorticular tubular centrifuge and the disc type centrifuge. So in that we have learnt the liquid containing the two phases with the two different densities can be separated from the solids by using the vorticular tubular centrifuge and also the disc type centrifuge. So in continuation with the last session topic, in this session we can also separate the solid from a fluid or from a slurry by a gravity settling process. Okay, that is a sedimentation process. So how exactly the sedimentation, what is sedimentation process and how exactly the sedimentation process can be carried out at a laboratory level, and also how it is being applied in various places, we will learn in this session. So today in this topic the contents will be the sedimentation, the brief about the sedimentation process and how exactly the sedimentation test will be conducted in the lab at the laboratory level, and also the references, and some of the MCQs also been given in based on the topic, the sedimentation. So sedimentation, as I already said, it is also a process where the solids are being separated from a liquid by a gravity settling. So that we call it as a sedimentation. Enandre gravity settling, just by allowing the liquid to settle, and gravity adashte kade settle agakke bitto solids matte liquid na separation madodanna nave enanta karitivi sedimentation anta karitivi, that is a by gravity settling. So ee process alli enagutte andre dilute slurry ene tagondirtivi adu will be separated into clear liquid matte ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಸ್ಲರಿ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಹೈ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಸಪ್ರೇಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಈ ಒಂದು ಸೆಡಿಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ನ ನಾವು ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಟ್ರೀಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವಾಟರ್. ಸೊ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸೇ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ದ ಸಸ್ಪೆಂಡೆಡ್ ಇಂಪ್ಯೂರಿಟೀಸ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಅಚೀವ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ದ ಸೆಡಿಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್. For example, if the water is allowed to stand or move very slowly through a basin until all the suspended impurities settles at so then we will get a clear water which can be withdrawn from the top, or it can be decanted from the top. So the degree of removal of suspended impurities will always depend upon and now eshtu mattige now impurities na ivu treatment of water yavdo ondo the water containing many of the impurities athwa dirty water na tagondive adalle silt irutte maya bare bare materials irutte adana remove martive by means of a sedimentation process. ee remove madu impurities remove madodu will depend upon the efficiency of the removal of the impurities will depend upon some of the factors. ಯಾವುದೆಲ್ಲ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸು, ದ ಲೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ರಿಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಪೀರಿಯಡು, ದ ಸೈಜ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸಸ್ಪೆಂಡೆಡ್ ಇಂಪ್ಯೂರಿಟೀಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಟೆಂಪ್ರೇಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಸಮ್ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಇವಾಗ ವಾಟರ್ ಟ್ರೀಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಸಮ್ ಟೆಂಪ್ರೇಚರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಆನ್ ಎಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಟೆಂಪ್ರೇಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವಾಟರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ದ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದ ಸೆಡಿಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ಮೆನಿ ದ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದ how they settle, so we have a free settling and a hinder settling process. So free settling process andre eno, free settling andre it is a process wherein all the particles in the gravitational field through a stationary fluid is not affected by the walls of the container or the other particles. Andre now ondo jar alli slurry tagontivi, we are allowing the particles to settle without disturbing by the gravity settling process. So eight particles irutho slurryly, that particles are not disturbed by any means in the sense they are not disturbed by the other particles which are trying to settle, and also the walls of the container, okay, they, which are not affected by the walls of the container. So aa vandu process ge namu en anta karithivi, free settling of the solids anta karithivi. Adanna navu helodu, it is a process wherein all the particles in the gravitational field through a stationary fluid, andre aa vandu stationary fluid alli, is not affected by the walls of the container and also other particles. So this is a free settling. So free settling will necessitate, and it will facilitate, that the particles will be at a sufficient distance from the wall of the container and also from the each other. The free settling condition no yavag irutte andre, if the concentration of the particles in the suspension is less than 1% by weight of the solids. Concentration of the solid particles in the suspension only 1% in the less idre by weight of the solids, then the free settling of the solids will happen in that particular slurry. So as the particles are trying to settle off, as the particle falls and they are trying to settle to the bottom of the container, its velocity increases, and it continue to increase, velocity increase agutte, adu continue to increase until the resistance force and the acceleration force due to gravity are equal. So resistance force and the acceleration force due to gravity equal aago varugu it tries to settle to the bottom, or they will fall. When such point is being reached, so all the particles will settle at a definite constant velocity during its further proceeding of the fall. So aa vandu velocity ne namu en anta karithivi, the terminal settling velocity athwa falling velocity. And the settling velocity of the settling velocity of the particle has been reached, that it is being reached to a maximum extent that they cannot, they further, if the time is being given, it doesn't settle. So when the a point reach aagibitte irutte aa vandu process ge aa vandu point ge navu enanta karthivi aa vandu velocity of that particle ge enanta karithivi antandre, it is being called as a terminal settling velocity or the falling velocity. So that's why as a particle falls, okay, its velocity increases, and velocity will continue to increase until the resistance force and the acceleration force of that particle due to gravity are equal. So at the point ali the particle will settle at a definite constant settling velocity during its remainder of its fall. So this velocity we call it as a terminal settling velocity or the falling velocity. So we have learned what is terminal settling velocity, what is free settling. So we will learn what is hinder settling. So you have a slurry, you have a concentration of the solids. If the concentration of the solids less than 1% by weight of the solids, then we have learned that it will take it as a free settling. So when it is more than 1% the concentration of the solids, okay, the concentration of the solids in the suspension is large, so particles a no ಒಂದಕ್ಕೊಂದು ತುಂಬ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ದೆ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಟು ಈಚ್ ಅದರ್, ದಟ್ ದ ಸರೌಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಇಂಟರ್ಫಿಯರ್ ದ ಮೋಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಅದರ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್. ಎರಡು ಕೊಲೈಡ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ರಶ್ ರಶ್ ಆಗಿ ಸೆಟ್ಲ್ ಆಗೋಕ್ಕೆ ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಆ ಒಂದು ಸಿಚುಯೇಷನ್ ನಾವೇನಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ, ಆ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಟ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಅನ್ನು ನಾವೇನಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ, ಹಿಂಡರ್ ಸೆಟ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಸೆಟ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಡಿಫೈನ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆನ್ ದ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸಸ್ಪೆನ್ಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಲಾರ್ಜ್, ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ಲಿ will be close to each other, particles will be close to each other, that the surrounding particles will interfere the motion of the other particles, and that process we call it as a hindered settling. So in this hindered settling condition, the settling velocity is considerably less than the terminal settling velocity under free settling condition. So hindered settling of sedimentation alli agutte. So particle is settling through the suspension of the particles in the fluid rather than through a fluid itself, so in the hindered settling process. So this is about what is the sedimentation, you have understood. So settling of the particles by simple gravity settling process we call it as a sedimentation process. And what is free settling, what is hindered settling, what is a terminal settling, so these all plays a very important role in the sedimentation process. So coming to the batch sedimentation test, which can be carried out in our laboratory.
So you can take a large, the transparent, the glass cylinder, which is a transparent. So you can take some amount of the solid, some concentration of the solid, say 3%, 3% is 30 grams of the solids in 1 liter of the water. You can make a slurry and you can transfer it to the cylindrical jar or the glass cylinder, we can say. So slurry is being uniformly agitated to have a uniform concentration. So uniform concentration ana now in constant level irutte 1 liter level alli irutte adana now z naught anta karithivi. Amele we are allowing the particle to settle by gravity. Let's see what happens after that. So different zones will be formed as the sedimentation. Now sedimentation, we are allowing the particles to settle by gravity settling, that is by sedimentation process in the we are allowing the particles to settle. Avaga we have a different zones formation. So the concentration of the solids is high enough that sedimentation of the individual particles is hindered by the other solids. Yes, to extent and the all the solids at a given level will settle at a common velocity. Beginningly, solid is uniformly distributed in the liquid, as it is being shown. The solids are being uniformly liquid, it is being shown in the diagram. So after a short time and we are allowing the particles to settle and on sulfur time and solids have settled to some solids have been settled to give a zone of clear liquid. So that zone we call it as a zone A in the diagram. You can see zone A here. This is a zone A. The particles are trying to settle. So after a short time, you have at the top of the cylinder, you have a clear liquid. So that way is represented by means of a zone A. So after, in the figure, and the zone D of a settled solids. Zone A nodudri, mathe zone D of settled solids. Some amount of the zone D, some amount of the solids will be settled. That we call it as a zone D. So above zone D is a transition layer. Zone D mele transition layer irutte. So which we call it as a zone C, in which the solid content varies from that is original pub to that in a zone D. So in a zone B, the concentration is uniform. You can see in a zone B, the concentration is uniform. And the particles are trying to settle. Since the settling rate is same in this throughout the zone, the boundaries between the zone D and C and the between the C and B, can you see C and D? The boundaries between the C and D and the C and B may not be distinct. And then clear again, now identify madakagala. But the boundary is between the zones A and B are sharp. So you know the boundaries between the B and C and the C and D. Okay, it is they are not clearly distinguishable. But the boundaries or the interface between the A and B are clearly distinguishable. And then clarity again concept. Clear liquid mele irutte madre kelage the particles are trying to settle down. As the settling continues, depth of the zone D and A will increase. And then solid settling jasti aagta hogutte madre clear liquid mele increase aagta hogutte. So the depth of the distance, you can say the depth of the zone C remains shown in the as shown in the figure. You can see as shown in the remain same as shown in the figure C here. So either the depth jaasti aagta hogutte and also D depth jaasti aagta hogutte and also A depth jaasti aagta hogutte. So the B zone disappears and all the solids are in as the settling process continues. Zone B enrate disappear agutte. Can you see the zone B will disappear? The solids will try to settle down. The gradual acclimation of the solids puts stress on the material at the bottom, which compresses the solids in the layer D. So process acta acta, there will be disappearance of the zone B and also zone C. You can also only see the zone A and D. So which is the concentration of the high content of the solids and the clear liquid at the above the zone D. So here almost all the solids are being settled in the zone D. So this is how by sedimentation, simple sedimentation test, you can separate the solids from the liquid. So after that you can decant this liquid. Okay, you can decant this liquid and you can take out the solids. And it can be dried further. So this is we have taken with a graphical representation of this, the time versus the depth. You have the glass cylinder here. Okay, you have a slurry. The slurry is trying to settle by the process of sedimentation. You can see the clear water region, the time. So the time beginning gradually decreases. The time of settling will gradually decreases with a decrease in time. So discrete settling zone, here we cannot the particles are trying to settle, flocculent settling region we call it as. Here the intersettling zone, because all the particles are trying to settle at the bottom. This is a compression region. So when the maximum time is being given for settling, the particles are being compressed at the bottom of the glass cylinder. So this is the sedimentation tank. You can see the flocculent feed and the feed well, the zone settling. You have a compression zone settling will take place. Then you have a sufficient time is being given and the zone settling A, B, C, D zone settling will take place. So then the solids finally will be settled at the bottom of the tank. And the racking mechanism is being given in order to take out all the solids from the tank, and it is being taken out as an underflow from beneath the tank. So overflow, and there is a clarification zone of the liquid. So and this sedimentation process is being application and tabandaga sedimentation usually ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಟ್ರೀಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರೀಸಲ್ಲಿ ಟ್ರೀಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್, ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ದ ಟ್ರೀಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸ್ಲಜ್ ಟ್ರೀಟ್ಮೆಂಟು, ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ ವೇಸ್ಟ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಟ್ರೀಟ್ಮೆಂಟು, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಡ್ರಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಟ್ರೀಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ವಿ ಯೂಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ದ ಕಾಮನ್ ಸೆಡಿಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟಿ ಟ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್. So this batch sedimentation, this diagram you have to remember if the question is being asked. They'll ask the brief about or illustrate the batch sedimentation test in a laboratory. And the you have to write all the diagrams A, B, C, D, E, indicating the zones of settling from the beginning A to beginning, ending with E. So I hope you have understood this concept. So having understood the concepts of sedimentation, let us solve some of the questions here, multiple choice questions. The question could be asked like this: when the impurities are separated by the gravitation of the settling particle, the operation is called what? I think you have got the answer already. It is a sediment. Whether it is a, the options are the sedimentation with a coagulant, or the plain sedimentation, or the secondary sedimentation, or disinfection. Think about the answer. So the answer is B, the plain sedimentation. So in which type of settling the sedimentation of the discrete particles takes place? This is also one possible question could be asked. So zone settling alla, compression settling alla, hinder settling alla, athwa discrete settling. The answer, discrete particles will be in a discrete settling obviously. So the third question will be, in which settling type the dilute suspension of the particles takes place? Zone settling alla, athwa compression settling alla, hinder settling alla, athwa discrete settling alla. The answer is in the hindered settling. ಸಸ್ಪೆನ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ನಿಧಾನಕ್ಕೆ ಸೆಟ್ಲ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಹಿಂಡರ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಹಿಂಡರ್ ಸೆಟ್ಲಿಂಗಲ್ಲಿ ದ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಒನ್ ಸೆಟ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅಫೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಪಾರ್ಟಿ ಸೆಟ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಅದರ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಆಬ್ವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಹಿಂಡರ್ ಸೆಟ್ಲಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ದ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಆಸ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ವೈಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನಿಂಗ್ ದ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಕುಡ್ ಬಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ದ ಲ್ಯಾಬ್ರೇಟರಿ ಬ್ಯಾಚ್ ಸೆಡಿಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಕುಡ್ ಬಿ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಕುಡ್ ಬಿ ಆಸ್ ಫಾರ್ 10 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಯು ಹವ್ ಕಮ್ ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ ದ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಸೆಟ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಂಡರ್ ಸೆಟ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್ ಸೆಟ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಸೊ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಕುಡ್ ಬಿ ದ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟಾಪಿಕ್ ವುಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಬಿ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಸೆಟ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿಂಡರ್ ಸೆಟ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಸೆಟ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಂಡರ್ ಸೆಟ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಕುಡ್ ಬಿ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಫಾರ್ 5 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಗೋ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬೀನ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಎಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬುಕ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಗವಾನೆ. ಸೊ ಫಾರ್ ಮೋರ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಯೂಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ಲಿಂಕ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದ ಬುಕ್ಸ್ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಫಾರ್ ಯು ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವೆರಿ ಆಪ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಡಿಪ್ಲೊಮೋ ಇಸ್ ಕೆ ಗವಾನೆ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ಸ್ 1 ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗೋ ಥ್ರೂ. I hope you understood from this session.